We have found new rings around Neptune. The first time we got a good look at Neptune's rings was in 1989, when the Voyager 2 spacecraft flew by the blue ice giant. That was also the last time we got a detailed look at Neptune's rings. Until now, this is JWST's view of the furthest planet in our solar system, Neptune. Yeah, I said what I said. The two brightest rings we have seen with Voyager 2 before, but if you look closely, you can see some faint dust rings that we have never seen before. Also in this photo are seven of Neptune's 14 known moons. Six are visible nice and close to Neptune. Can you guess where the seventh moon is? It's not this one, it's this one, the one that kind of looks like a star. This is Neptune's largest moon, Triton, which wildly outshines the planet. The reason for that is pretty cool. Triton reflects around 70% of the sunlight that falls on it, which JWST picks up really well. Neptune, however, appears relatively dark because of the methane in its atmosphere, which is also responsible for its characteristic blue color in visible light. This is because methane primarily absorbs red and infrared light, leaving behind mostly blue light. And since JWST sees an infrared light, the light that gets absorbed by much of Neptune's atmosphere, it appears dark to JWST. Those brighter patches are clouds high in the atmosphere of Neptune. They reflect more sunlight before it gets absorbed by the methane, making it look brighter than the deeper atmosphere. And get keen, Neptune and Triton fans, because there are additional studies planned for both objects next year.